In this video, we are going to understand and visualize at the certain abstraction level what is Gaussian distribution, what is Gaussian noise, what is white Gaussian noise, that is WGN, and what is additive white Gaussian noise, that is AWGN. So we would be using MATLAB simulation. The code of this simulation is given in the description of this video. So using this simulation, we would look into a stem time series plot. So for this random process, we would look into a probability density function of white Gaussian noise. Next, we would move on towards autocorrelation function of white noise. Later on, we would look into power spectral density of white noise. And lastly, we would look into how additive white Gaussian noise affects a given signal. Note that noise is prevalent in most systems. Let us restrict ourselves to a particular system, that is a communication system. Here we have a broadcast station. And this broadcast station is transmitting a signal wirelessly to a user. So we have a user device, that is a cell phone. This device has an antenna. So the EMT wave which was transmitted from the broadcast station would be received at the receive antenna of the user device. Now within this receive antenna, there is a random movement of electrons which are agitated and they dissipate and unwanted energy. So this is a random process. So the emerging signal often is a Gaussian noise which has a probability density function referred over here in this expression. And it has a plot which is referred to over here. This mu is the mean value or the average value, where the sigma is a standard deviation and the square of it is variance. And variance defines or identifies the dispersion in data. Note that the Gaussian distribution is also referred to as normal distribution or a bell-shaped distribution. We call this bell-shaped because the opening of this bell is controlled by the variance sigma square, such that if the variance has a higher value, so we would have a bigger opening as compared to a lower variance value. Now, for random noise, as we have considered previously, the mean value is often set to zero. X follows a normal distribution, which has a certain mu. And that mu is equal to 0 in present case, and the variance is sigma square. So as mu is equal to 0, so over here we have a 0 mean random variable. That is, this is a 0 mean probability density function of white Gaussian noise. Now if we want to find the probability of having a value between minus 2 and say minus 0.1, so all we need to do is to find the area in this region. So we would find the probability between minus 0.2 and minus 0.1. Do note that integrating the PDF curve from minus infinity to infinity would yield a value of 1. Now let us relate this random variable with our random process. And that random process is over here, and this is a stem time series plot. So let us hold our horses for the white aspect for the time being. Now over here, this is an outcome of a random variable, and particularly this is the first outcome. Similarly, we can have the second outcome and third outcome and so on. So this random process can be expressed as P of t. Note that this is a time domain plot. Now for such random process, we cannot take the Fourier transform directly, because in that scenario we would have to take the Fourier transform of each realization, and then we have to take the average value to find the power spectral density. An alternate mean is to find the autocorrelation function. Let us revisit the random process that we referred to as P of t previously, and we can find the autocorrelation function, which is denoted by R. And this is a function of tau. Again, we have the random process, which is P of t. And then we multiply this random process with a shifted version of itself, where p of t plus tau is a shifted version, shifted in time domain, of this random process, which is p of t. And the amount of shift is controlled by this variable, which is tau. So if this is p of t, the second plot is that of p of t plus tau, and we shift it. And in the shift, at each increment of this shift, we multiply and take the expectation. So in this way, we will find our autocorrelation function. Again, that is the correlation of this process with the time shifted version of itself, and which is plotted over here. An important property of white noise is that the autocorrelation function only exists when the lag or time shift is zero. That is, when you set this tau equal to zero, so you would have p of t multiplied by p of t, and then we would take the expectation. So this is basically the variance of the distribution. So hence, for a white noise, we have an autocorrelation function, and that autocorrelation function is equivalent to sigma square delta of tau, and for all other lags the value is zero. You would also come across a terminology which is often referred to as IID, and this is referred to a distribution which is independent and identically distributed random variable. So that is, the outcome, which is this one, is independent of this outcome. However, both of them follow an identical distribution, which is Gaussian in our case. Now, using this autocorrelation function, we can reach the power spectral density by simply taking the Fourier transform. That is, we have a random process P of t. We take the autocorrelation function of that, so we reach R of tau. And finally, we can take the Fourier transform of this R of tau to get back the power spectral density, which is often denoted by S P of F. Now, for the case of autocorrelation function, we referred that for white noise, the autocorrelation function exists only for a time delay of zero, and it is zero elsewhere. Now, for the PSD, and in the context of white noise, the power is distributed equally among all frequencies. So this is an important consideration. For all frequencies, the power is distributed equally. And that is basically 10 log 10 of our variance to get that power in dB scale. And that is over here, which is 20. Note that sigma in our experimentation, we have set it to 0.01. which is also appearing over here, that is, this is 0.01 delta of t, and in the coding it appears over here. Now, in the context of additive white Gaussian noise, so consider that we have a signal which is simply a sine wave, and that sine wave is represented by this bold line. So if we add white Gaussian noise to it, that is additive white Gaussian noise, so we would have some fluctuations or attenuations, and this level of spread would be based on the distribution that we have considered previously, that is the Gaussian distribution, and the spread is controlled by the variance, that is sigma square. Now let us move towards the MATLAB plot, and in this MATLAB plot we have included a preamble over here, and in this preamble we have run the experiment for 10 seconds, that is the time t in line 5 would start from 0 and it would terminate at time span which is 10 seconds with the increment of this sampling time ts, which is equal to 1 over fs, and the sampling frequency we have set to 10,000 hertz. In line 6, this capital L identifies the total number of samples that would be taken, and they are dependent on t. And next we include some statistical parameters, including the mean value, which is mu, variance, which we have set to 0.01, the standard deviation, which is the square root of variance, and again the variance in dB scale, that is 10 log 10 of variance VAR. So in line 14, we generate the random process, that is capital X is equal to square root of the variance times rand n, that is random normal, which has L number of rows and one column plus the mu, which is mean, but anyhow we have set the mean equal to 0. So next we plot this random variable in figure 1 by using a stem plot, that is the plot in discrete time events, and we include some aesthetics in terms of title and labels. Moreover, we limit the axis, specifically the x-axis. Why we have limited? Because the total number of samples that we consider are 100,000. This is the length of L previously mentioned, but that would be too much data to analyze, so we are just going to visualize 0 to 25 samples initially, and until keyboard the simulation would yield this plot, which is a time series plot of the random process of white Gaussian noise. So let us understand further this white Gaussian noise of 100,000 samples by means of an audio signal. So what would be the sound of a white Gaussian noise? And to play the sound in MATLAB from line 26 to 28, we have set a command specifically into line 27, that is sound of X, and that sound is. This one. Now for the plot of the probability density function of the Gaussian random variable, we have used figure 2 and we have used specifically the command that is ks density of the random process x, right? And then that is plotted over here in figure 2 with some labeling. While for the autocorrelation function, we have used x correlation and included the biased option as an argument of the correlation function, and this correlation function would give us the autocorrelation function at different values of lag, which are plotted in figure number 3. So until this keyboard in line number 50, let us run the experiment. So now we have two different plots. The first plot is the PDF of white Gaussian noise, whereas the second plot is the autocorrelation function. So previously in figure 1, we mentioned that this is our random process, and if we take the correlation function, which is this one, and then if we take the Fourier transform of this function, we would reach the power spectral density. But applying the Fourier transform directly on this autocorrelation function in the present scenario is not giving us the power spectral density. And the reasons for such is that our present simulation deals with a pseudo-random kind of a number. Moreover, these lags are finite in duration. So an alternate route to finding the power spectral density is adopted from this reference. It is changed a little bit, and in figure 4 we reshape the random process X into a matrix of 1000 rows by 100 columns. That is, we partition X into 100 random processes, and each random process has 1000 realizations, and we have referred this matrix as X1. So we take the fast Fourier transform of this X1, then we normalize it. In line 60, we compute the mean power from this FFT. Again, we normalize the x-axis, and from line 63 onwards until line 69, we perform some display settings of the PSD plot. So until line 69, let us run the experiment to plot the PSD, which is over here in dB per hertz. Now for the additive white Gaussian noise in figure 5, we generate a new signal, and this signal is simply a sine wave. So we time scale that sine wave by a factor of 2 and also multiply by 2 as a constant coefficient, so that this new signal is of a certain strength. And on this new signal we include the white Gaussian noise that we have previously created, and from 76 onwards until line number 82, we display the settings and label them. So let us run the experiment. Again, the dark red is identifying the original signal, whereas the signal with AWGN is indicated by this green waveform. So if we increase the noise power, that is, we set this variance to say 0.1 and evaluate this selection. Next, we again perform this AWGN analysis. Now in this plot, you can observe that the noise is playing a much bigger role as compared to previous situation, where the noise was simply 0.01.